My name is Alone, and welcome to another Zero to Hero episode. I will start this off by doing some Solra, and I wanna try to reach a 100 kill count all the way from 14. So I hope you guys will enjoy the episode. What is the first loot going to be? Chaos Runes, Solra skills, and Flax. Not bad. I felt like this kill was pretty fast, the second one. Okay, 2 minutes, almost 3 seconds off the PB, so hopefully I can get that below 2 minutes as of my personal best. Don't worry, by the way, I won't show every single kill, but just the first ones. So third kill, some U-Logs and Manta Rays. I actually stopped using Void and I went for full switches instead, and it's definitely better. I mean, the kill time was slower now, but it's just because I'm not used to switching that many gear items yet. Okay, this kill was definitely better. I think this might be a PB. Oh, double Solandra teleports as well. Oh, 2 minutes and 9 seconds, 3 seconds again off PB. Bit of a milestone, I guess. 20kc incoming, 80 more to do for the video. Palm tree seed is not too bad. My god, look at the kill time. 1 minute and 38 seconds. I just blasted that. I just got the luckiest hits ever on my kill number 32. That is just insane kill time. For some reason, I didn't know this, but the Malediction Ward is actually very cheap, and it's also better than the Book of Darkness. I actually thought the Book of Darkness had higher offensive bonus, but nope, this Malediction Ward has +2 to magic offense and also higher defense bonus. Oh god, I have no more food. If the Snakeling hits me... Okay, dude. That was so close as well. That's actually my first death on Solra so far. Feels bad, dude. Hey, 50 kill count done. The drop is not too great, Death Runes, but yeah, halfway to the 100 mark, Malediction Ward is doing great. Yeah, dude, this is... if I get hit by a ranged attack here, I'm probably dead, so I'm gonna have to soon get my spec as well. That is a Come on, dude! Oh, the boss died! Wait, oh yeah, I can't pick up the loot. Okay, it wasn't something special anyways, but... Oh, come on, dude. I'm actually going to make another purchase, which is this thing. The Serpentine Helm. And I had like 9k scales. So I just put them into the helm instantly, and I got all of them from Solra. So the reason why is because then I don't have to bring an anti-venom, and also I don't have to bring a helm switch. First kill with the Serpentine Helmet. Look at the kill time. 149. Not too far off my PB, and it is so relaxing to use this. We are getting... really close to 100kc, 99, and the kills I do lay around 2 minutes pretty much every single time. So here I am on my last kill, and I feel like I really got this boss down now. I was really scared about how it has like different rotations every single time, felt like I had to write everything down. But if you just do it a bit, you kinda just get into it and you can adapt very easily. So wait, did I just get Adamant Javelins? That's actually like 1 in 1000 drop rate. Fuck. With all those kills done, let's have a look at the loot tracker. 86 kills, as I said, I started with 14. 10.5 mil, that is over 100k per kill, and the kills are every 2 minutes pretty much. So that is just phenomenal. Now for the short skilling part of this video, hopefully, I'm going to do 70 smithing in the Blast Furnace. It is very easy, I bought 10,000 gold ore. For actually just below 2 mil, it's very cheap, and I think it should be almost enough for 70 smithing. So here you go, I have just started using them, and the method is just, you run all the way up here, you have your goldsmith gauntlets on, you put the gold ore on the conveyor belt up here, you wait just a second, yes, and then you go down here, you wait for the experience drop on the right side, there you go, 1.5k. Put on the ice gloves, and you just take it out, and you do that every single time. Actually, I have to run a lot in the Blast Furnace, so I'm just going to use my Marks of Grace to get some graceful items to make it a bit less annoying. Oh no! I missed one single Marks of Grace to buy another piece, so I guess I'll just do some agility to get one of those and I can buy another piece. Come to me, Marks of Grace, give me that. That actually took a very long time, like 10 laps. I am going to go with the cape, and then I only missed the boots after that. I'm looking pretty good. So something very unfortunate happened. I actually had finished my entire video. It was about 12 minutes long, and then when I rendered it and finished all of it, pretty much all of it was gone. I mean, I only rendered 4 minutes and then I deleted all the footage and I thought it was done. So up to this part of the video, it was from the old video, and then from now on will be after I had actually completed all that. So I will just give you a quick rundown on what you missed out on. I got 70 smithing through the Blast Furnace, which was very easily done with the gold ore. So I only miss 70 hunter and 70 mining for the elf quest. and also 70 farming, which I've been working on quite a bit with tree runs, the orange tree seeds and the maple trees. So almost 120,000 experience there, so getting closer to 70. Also, I did kill 50 scorpia, so I will add a 50 kill count to that in the end, and I can check the collection log for you guys later. I unfortunately don't have the loot tracked on the Runelite plugin for it, because I deleted that as well. But yeah, that's pretty much all I did, and also I got 60% Hosidius favor, so I can enter the farming guild, because I did get a Hespori seed, but I still need 65 farming to be able to use it. So I've killed a bit more Solra actually, and I'm now on 151 KC. I was going to end the video on 100, but there we go, 151, still no uniques, so I'm actually dry now. So I guess the skilling portion of this video instead will be some hunter and maybe some farming as well. I'm going to passively do that during the entire video, so I will just show the milestones. Maybe I can reach 60 farming in this video. Then we only have 10 farming levels to go, 5 mining levels, and I will probably get 65 hunter. First level coming in, 61 hunter, 2 more for red chins. Just barely missed the level pop-up, but that is 62, 1 more for red chins. So even though I can now catch red chins, I'm not going to do that. I'll do red salamanders to 65 because I don't have the diary for red chins. You can see my farming counter on the top right, getting some more experience on it, but that is also 64. That will be the last level I'll gain in hunter for this video, 65 hunter, so let's get back to PVMing, I think. I'll hunt for some boss tasks from Slayer, and that is a pretty good one. 152 Dagonoths. Let's see if we can get a ring from that. Oh, okay, that is definitely not what I want to see at the end of my task. I have 29 kills left to do, and I get a Warrior's Ring. It's only 42k. So here's the overall loot that I got. I actually got a Circle as well, but the loot is pretty decent, I would say. It's just pretty good normal loots if you don't get any rares, but the rares are obviously where the money is at. That is a very hefty Avianzi task. Pretty good, 182. I mean, hefty as I don't have them extended, and I'm also very close to 60 farming. First kill, can we get an item on the first drop? We cannot. We're starting on 115 KC. I am guessing I, in this task with Ecumenical Keys, will probably end at like 150 KC, which is pretty good progress, I would say. Decent chance of getting an item as well. Holy shit! Armadill Hilt! That is a very nice drop. I mean, it's not the most valuable thing. The helm is definitely worse. But the crazy thing is, I need to show you guys my collection log in just a sec. Look how insane this is. 139 KC. I have every single drop, including the pets, except the chain skirts. Just nuts. So we're getting closer to the end, 41 Avianzis left, and I get a God Sword Shard 3. It's definitely not a great drop, but 150k is not too bad. No way, dude. This can't be real. A second Armadillo Hilt on 148 KC. My log is just insane now. I mean, that has been the most insane task ever. I mean, it's not the most valuable drops you can get, but 2 Armor Hilts in what, 40 kills or something? Jesus. Pretty huge level incoming here, actually. 60 farming when I check this tree. So now I can actually plant yew trees. So I will keep doing that. And only 10 more levels until I have the farming requirement to be able to do Song of the Elves. And then I need 65 to 70 mining and 65 to 70 hunter. I missed doing the 550 task on Konar, but still decent points, I guess. Oh nice, 116 Kraken kills, getting closer to 1k on that boss. Going to make a very good upgrade here. I'm going to sell my 2 Armadill Hilts. Let's see what they actually sell for. Okay, they don't sell for the medium price, but what I want to do is I want to buy a Tormented Bracelet. I was thinking about buying an Imbued Heart, but I don't think it's equally good to a Tormented Bracelet, so I'm going to get that first. And the Imbued Heart is just cheese on top of it, I guess. But 22.5 mil, so that is definitely enough to get the Tormented Bracelet, which is a very, very good mage upgrade. 17.6 mil, not too bad, I guess, but let's look at that. 12% magic damage to 17, and also a pretty decent magic attack bonus. Believe it or not, that is my third Jar of Dirt, and I'm also soon at 900 KC, but I won't get 1k on this task, unfortunately. So I actually want to do some more Solra now that I have the Tormented Bracelet. It's going to be very, very useful here, and I want to reach a total of 200 kills in this video. I'm currently at like 130, so my end KC will be about 214, I think. I felt like this was a very quick kill. Let's see the kill time on this one. 146. Okay, that's not super fast, but it's not definitely not bad, and the bracelet is very accurate now. This might be a potential PB. Let's see what the time is. Oh, 137. That's 6 seconds off the PB, but definitely, you can see the kills are consistently close to my PB now, at least. Hey, finally, Serpentine Visage. That's the first drop, and it's actually not bad. 5 mil worth on 169k. See, I think that's slightly unlucky, actually, but yeah, I was scared I wouldn't get one single drop in 200k. Okay, so this is actually a very fast kill, I feel like, and it's actually the last kill that I would do. 132. Oh, that was so close to the PB. But yeah, that's going to be the last kill for this video, and the last boss kill for it as well. But let's look at the loot. So from the Kraken task, I got 2.7 mil, which is not bad. I always like doing that task, very easy. Then look at this, Kriara, 38 kills, 2 Armadale hilts, 23 mil. And then for the big one, Solra, 27.7 mil. And the Serpentine Visage was 4.8 mil. And the scales is 10.3 mil. So the consistent money that you get from Solra is really, really good. And in general, I'm very happy with being way more confident with Solra in general now. So I have one more tree to check after this one, but that won't give me a whole level. So 64 farming is where I'm going to end the farming grind for this video as well. So we only need 6 more levels to be done with farming. So let's have a look at the boss progress. So we added pretty much 200 kills to Solra, which is the big one for this video. And then also a decent amount to each Dagonoth King, getting at least all of them above 200 KC. And then we also added 38 KC to Kriara. So on the second slide, there's not that much of a difference. The major differences are I completed Scorpia and added 50 kill count to that. And as I said earlier in the video, that footage is unfortunately just gone because of my own mistake. But it is done nonetheless, and it's not one of the most impressive bosses really in the game, so not too sad about that anyways. But we're pretty close also to 1000 Kraken KC, only 35 more, so on the next task I will be above 1000. And I almost forgot to actually show this, but here you go, this is the evidence. I got no drops at all, so as I said, not too interesting in those 50 kills. But anyways, that is going to do it for this video. I do hope you guys did enjoy it, and if you did, please leave a like. And remember to subscribe if you want to see my future uploads in this series. And I'm also doing a PKing series that I just started, so if you want to see that, you can check that out. It will be on the screen right now on the cards. So have a good one, guys. Take care.